By the end of this video, you're going to understand the difference between Zapier and Make, and hopefully know which automation tool you want to use for your next workflow project. Zapier and Make are both powerful platforms that enable you to automate tasks and connect with different apps without writing any code. Price is a big consideration for most people, which we'll get to later, but one of the big differences between Zapier and Make that I want to start with is how they handle workflow complexity and integration capabilities. Here we have Zapier and Make side by side. On the left side, we have Zapier, and on the right side, we have Make. I'm going to talk a little bit about the dashboards and the comparisons between them. So one thing that's really nice with Zapier is they have this AI feature where you can just type what you want it to create, and then it's going to create the structure of that Zap or automation. When I say Zap, I really mean automation within Zapier. And with Make, on the other hand, they don't have that type of AI feature. You have to actually go ahead and click the plus button and create a new Zap. Otherwise, I would say it's pretty similar. You can see how many operations you have. You can see some templates here. I would say Zapier is a little easier to get started for a beginner because of the AI feature that they have and some of these templates that they have, as well as down here, just complete solutions where they're going to tell you how to use Zapier for different use cases. So here in Make, it's a little bit more technical, or it seems more technical from the onset, and they don't have these templates or things to help you get started. So that's something just to keep aware of. So if we go up, what I'm gonna do is create a really simple automation with both Zapier and Make, and you're gonna see side by side what it's like to create these automations. I'm going to go ahead and use Zapier's AI feature. So I'm going to say I want to create an automation where when I submit a Google form, when someone submits a Google form, I get an email. And then let's just go ahead and click generate. So what this should do is create a Zap where the trigger is a Google form, and then we're going to send email as the second step. So this is great. It's really good for these simple automations and getting started. So I'm just going to go ahead and click try it. And you can see right off the bat, it's set up for us. And I can even expand the page a little bit so you can see, you can kind of zoom in and out and see what the how the workflow is set up. And then here on the right side, you just have to connect your account. So here it's telling me to reconnect my Google account. So I'm going to pause the video and do that really quickly. Okay, great. So now my Google form is connected, my Google account. So then we can click continue. It's going to ask us for a trigger. So then we're going to choose a form. And in my case, I'm just going to choose this form, weekly newsletter feedback. It's a form that I created a while ago, but if I click continue, I can use it to demonstrate how this works. So if you don't have a Google form, you'd want to create it first and then connect it to Zapier. So I'll click test trigger, and here we are seeing one of the responses that someone gave, and this is one of the responses that someone gave to the no-code MBA newsletter. If you want to subscribe, you can go to nocode.mba/updates, and here this person says, I like that I can pace my lessons around my schedule, and a few other things. But really what's just important is that there is at least one response in your Google form so that you can have this test response here. So we're gonna say continue with selected record. And now we have step two, which is send email. So I'm gonna click continue. Again, I'm gonna connect Gmail. So you need to connect your Gmail account. I'm gonna pause and do that. So now I've connected Gmail. We can click continue. And then we would just fill out this information about who we want to send it to. So I could send it to myself at set.nocode.mba. It can be from set.nocode.mba. That's the Gmail that I connected. It's a new survey response. And then the body, we can pull in the response. So it could be, for example, have been put on our newsletter. And this is the response that that user submitted here. And you can go ahead and click continue. You can click test step, which is going to send an email right off the bat. So I can see that I did get an email. So that worked correctly. And then all you'd have to do is go ahead and click publish. So once you click publish, your Zap is now live. And now anytime you get a new Google Form response, you're going to get an email and sent to yourself. That was just a really quick setup of building an automation in Zapier. And now I'm going to build the same automation in Make so you can see the difference and see how it's set up. So I'm going to click create a new scenario. In Make, they call them scenarios. So we have different steps here, and you can kind of put it anywhere you want. It's kind of like a flowchart that you can work with, which I personally like. And we're going to go ahead and click the plus button. We're going to search for Google Form and just select Google Form. And then what we're going to say is we're going to watch responses, which is going to trigger when a new response is received. So already off the bat, you can see it's a little more complicated if you are brand new to Make and you don't know how it works. You might not know to go, go down to response and click watch, watch responses. So right off the bat, Zapier is going to be a little bit easier to use if you're brand new to all of this. So now we're going to get the form ID. You could just search, and I believe I just have to make sure that my... okay, so the connection is live. Okay, so now it's searching, and we can find the same form, which is weekly newsletter feedback. We're going to have the limit of one, so it's going to only give me one response at a time, and I'm going to click OK. Choose when to start, from now on or since a specific date. I'll just say from now on. I'm going to start from now on. Then we add another module. And then what we're going to do is search for Gmail and click send an email. Where this is a little bit more straightforward, but you click subject. I can just say new response and hard code that in. And then for content, you can just go down and click on that example. And this I actually like a little bit better than Zapier. I think it's a little more straightforward to kind of understand, okay, this is dynamic content that we're pulling in here. And that's it. So you go ahead and click OK. Whoops, I have to add a recipient. So I'll do that to myself. And we'll click OK. And here we go. So now we have this set up. And then all you would do is turn this on. Or actually, first you have to save it. So it's telling me what I need to do, which is pretty helpful. And then also, Make does have this AI feature similar to Zapier, but it's inside the actual scenario as opposed to on the home screen for Zapier. So a little different, but you can use it in a very similar way. Also use it to edit the scenario or add additional features, which is pretty helpful. So I'm going to close this out for now. Then I'm going to go ahead and make sure I save it. So now it was saved. And now I could turn it on. So now that it's turned on, every time there's a Google form that is submitted to that specific form, we're going to send that same email. You be the judge which one you think is easier, Zapier or Make. I think in some ways Zapier is easier, and then in some ways Make is actually a little bit simpler and easier. I think Zapier is a little bit easier to get started with, and Make, I think, is actually really easy once you know how it works. So there's just a little bit more of a learning curve, but it's still pretty easy. But there's a little bit more of a learning curve here with Make. So pretty cool. We built the same exact automation here with both Zapier and Make. Now I'm going to talk about some of the more advanced functionality that you can build into these platforms. So I'm going to start with Make here. So right off the bat, Make makes it really easy to add modules. You can have different flows. So if you want to have flow controls and kind of repeat things or iterate through things, Make has that advanced functionality built in really easily. You can have a router. So based on different responses, we can send things to different paths. So kind of a multi-path automation, which is really useful. There's also the ability to add in API calls. So the way to do this is through HTTP. And this gets a little more complicated, so I'm not going to go into it in this specific tutorial. But by using HTTP, we actually have another video where we show you how to set up a full social media automation that connects to OpenAI using Make. And with that, you could learn how to use HTTP in that video. In this video, I'm just going to kind of go over as an overview, but it allows you to make API calls basically to places like OpenAI and add that functionality in. You also can search for OpenAI and use kind of the integrated integration that they have. But I also like using HTTP when I understand the API, because it just gives me a little bit more control over the connection. So that's how you do some of those types of advanced features in Make. And then in Zapier, you can do a lot of the same things. So let's click Edit Zap just to show you what's possible. So if we go down here and I click Add Step, so there's a few things that you can see. So first we have paths, we have filters, we have different things to similar to what we did in Make to kind of have the Zap take action based on different criteria. So if you click paths, for example, now we have two different paths, and Zapier, I think, does a really good job of building this out. So Zapier has something called Webhooks by Zapier, and also you can see that it is a pro feature, a premium feature. In general, this is something we're going to get to a little bit more later, but Zapier is a little bit more expensive. Things like this with Zapier using webhooks, you can send similar types of API calls as you can do here. With a lot of those advanced features are available on both of the platforms. The next thing I'm going to cover is integrations. So integrations are apps that are built into both Zapier and Make and allow you to really easily connect to them. So Zapier has a lot more integrations. Zapier has about 7,000 integrations, while Make has about 1,800 integrations. Now, both of them are going to be integrated with all of the most popular apps that you're likely using. So in my personal experience, I haven't found it to be an issue that Make doesn't integrate with as many as Zapier, but it's definitely possible that an app that you use integrates with Zapier and doesn't integrate with Make. So just as a result of that, you might have to use Zapier, because if the app doesn't integrate with Make, you're just not going to be able to use it. So in terms of integrations, Zapier definitely has more. So now we're going to compare pricing. So Zapier has their free plan at 100 tasks per month, while Make has their free plan at 1,000 operations per month. Now, the way to think about a task versus an operation is in the example that we built, where we built a Google form sending to a Gmail email. In Make, that's two operations, and in Zapier, that's one task. So depending on how complex your tasks and automations are in Make, it can be more operations. But in general, I find it to be a lot more economical to use Make than to use Zapier. Zapier is, I think, just more expensive for most of the use cases that you're going to want. But on the other hand, it is a little bit easier to get started with. There's a lot more apps that it integrates with. And for those reasons, it might be the right choice for you. So it just depends on what your use case is and which apps you want to integrate with. But if you can learn Make, I definitely recommend it, because it is a lot less expensive, especially as you scale up with your automations. The last thing that I'm going to go over is reliability. Here we are on both the Zapier and Make status pages, and both of them have extremely high uptime. So we can see that Make is 99.96% uptime for responsive webhooks, 99.98% for scenario execution. If we go to Zapier, it's 99.98% for polling trigger reliability. So in general, the reliability is really good for both. And I personally feel comfortable building automations that are important for my business on both Zapier and Make. If you want to learn how to build with Zapier and Make in your own projects, check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA and check out all of our No Code courses. So I hope that this was a helpful overview of Make and Zapier, and you have an idea of which one you want to use for your business. I personally use Zapier for certain tasks, and I use Make for other tasks. Specifically, if I want to connect to APIs or build things that are a little more complex, I like using Make for that. And also, as I'm scaling things up, Make is a little bit less expensive. But for more simple automations, I tend to use Zapier. So I like using both. They're both able to do a lot of things, and they both can get pretty complex as well, depending on what you want to build with it.